Want to learn engineering and science? Well, you've tuned in to the right channel. Hit subscribe and press the bell icon and never miss an update from us.
Hi there guys, how are you doing? This is your friend and tutor Manas, and in today's session, we're going to be talking about a problem based on method of sections. So let's see what the problem has in store. Here we go. Well, it goes like this. Find the axial force in the members 1 and 2. So this is member 1, that is FD you can say, and this is member 2, DE. All right. So initially, what we're going to do is, we'll try to find the reaction at supports. Here, at point F, we have sort of a hinged support, and hinged, there are going to be two forces, okay? One horizontal, while the other vertical. And at point G, we have a roller support, and hinged, we're going to have a reaction normal to this surface. All right. So this over here is what you call VF, and this over here is what you call HF, okay? And this is exactly what we call RG, simply. All right, the first thing that I need to do is apply the equations of equilibrium. Now, let me select a pen. Let me use a blue color for this purpose. So I'm going to initially go ahead by using this first equation of equilibrium. Summation of all the forces in x direction is equal to 0. And guys, if you watch carefully, there are only two forces acting in the x direction. One is HF, okay, right hand side positive. Other one is RG, again, right hand side positive. So essentially what needs to be done is HF plus RG is going to be equal to 0. So you can write this again as HF is equal to negative of RG. Okay, that's all. Secondly, we'll be using this equation of equilibrium. Summation of all the forces in y direction is equal to 0. And guys, if you watch carefully, these are the three forces, VF, 2 kN, and 3 kN. All of them are headed downwards and hence negative. So what we're going to do is minus of VF minus 2 minus 3, all of this is going to be equal to 0. And what I need to do is and write VF is equal to negative of 5 kN. So we've got the value of vertical force at point F. Okay, now I'm going to go ahead and use this final equation of equilibrium, moment about a specific point, and let's see, we are going to take moment about the hinge, that is at F is equal to 0. When you do so, since these two forces are passing through this point F, their moments are going to be 0. Therefore, we are only left with three forces, that is RG, this 2 kN and this 3 kN force. Now guys, if you watch carefully, this 2 kN force tries to produce a clockwise moment at point F, hence a negative sign, minus name of the force is 2, multiplied by, this is the force and this is the perpendicular distance. If you watch carefully, for force 2 kN, we've got this FB as the perpendicular distance, whose value is equal to 2 plus 2, that's 4. So I can write over here 4. That's it. What about this 3 kN force? This force also tries to produce a clockwise moment at point F. N is a negative sign, minus magnitude is 3, multiplied by the perpendicular distance. Obviously, this perpendicular distance is going to be FA. Okay, so for 3 kN force, if you try to drop a perpendicular from point F, it's going to be this, that is FA, whose value is nothing but 2 plus 2 plus 2, that is 6. Okay, there is one more force left. So about point F, if you try to take the moment about RG, this produces an anti-clockwise moment. Hence a positive sign, okay, name of the force is RG, multiplied by, this is the force RG and this is the perpendicular distance, that is FG, whose value is 2 meters. So I'm going to multiply this by 2. All of this stuff is going to be equal to 0. And finally, you need to solve this equation. So 2, 4 is 8, 6, 3 is 18, 18 and 8 is 26. 26 goes over here, it becomes positive. 26 divided by 2 will give you the value of RG is equal to 13 kN, simply. Okay, so you just need to put the value of RG over here so that you can get the value of HF, and HF will work out as negative of 13 kN. Now that the reaction at supports have been computed, we'll go ahead and we'll try to find this angle. Let me do a little bit of construction. Okay, so this is sort of an inclined member over here. Let me do this construction. Let's have a horizontal line and let's get two vertical lines from point E, okay, something of this sort, and from point C. Yeah, there you go. And let's just say this point is point P, and let us say this point is point Q. So what I need is, I need this angle. And let's for now say that this angle is represented by theta. Now, if you watch carefully, when we consider, I'm talking about triangle GQC. GQC, if you take tan theta, what happens? Tan theta is equal to this much distance. Now guys, if you watch carefully, this distance from point B to point Q, this is 2 meters. And this distance from B to point C, this is 1.5 meters. And in CQ will be equal to 2 minus 1.5. Okay, so this small distance over here, this small distance, if I can make this over here, 1.5 meters. So essentially what we need to do is tan theta is equal to perpendicular, that is 1.5 divided by the space from point G to point Q, which is equal to nothing but 4. You just need to solve this equation and you're going to get the value of theta is equal to 7.125, well, approximately. Fine, now we come to the business portion of this particular problem. So we want to find the axial forces along members 1 and 2. Okay, so let me just write this, applying method of sections. Okay, so essentially what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to pass a section which is going to cut members 1 and 2. Okay, something of this sort. And you can clearly see that this section, apart from cutting 1 and 2, also cuts this EC member. Okay, let's say this EC member is member 3, you can say. Alright, now this section is clearly dividing the truss into two separate portions, and at the same time it is cutting three members. And in order to find three unknown axial forces, we are going to be using the three equations of equilibrium, moment zero, fx zero and f of y zero. Okay, so let's have the forces approaching this section line from both the directions. Here we go, from the left and from the bottom we have these so-called orange colored forces, and from the right and from the top we have these so-called green colored forces. You can see if this is member 1, let's say the force along this member be represented by F1, force along this member 2 is represented by F2, and finally we've got this as F3. Okay, now we need to apply method of sections. Now guys, as I've already told you before in the previous problems also, this selection of point for taking moment is basically a hit and trial approach. Okay, I'm going to straight away select this point E. All right, now take a moment about point E. Why? Let me tell you. As I've already told, that point for moment has to be selected, which lets you frame a moment equation with only one unknown axial force. Okay, now if you pick point E, okay, since this is below the section and hence forces above the section are to be considered, okay, or the upper portion of the section has to be considered, these green colored forces I'm talking about. If you watch carefully, F3 and F2, both of them are passing through point E, and hence their moments are going to be zero. All right, the only force that we are left with is this F1. That means if you try to take moment about point E, it will let you frame a moment equation, and in that F of 1 is going to be the only unknown axial force. That's why we are taking moment about point E is equal to zero. So let's go ahead and do that. Okay, so point E is below the section line and hence forces above the section line are to be considered. Okay, so F3 and F2, since they are passing through E, they are out of the picture, their moments are zero, and hence we are left with this F1 and this 2 kN force and this 3 kN force. Now guys, if you watch carefully, this F1 force, this green colored F1, produces an anti-clockwise moment at E. Hence, we have to use a positive sign. Name of the force is F1 multiplied by, now if this is the force, line of action of force F1, okay, from right to left of your screen, this is going to be the perpendicular distance, that is DE. Alright, so let me write DE over here. Fine, what else is there? Now this 2 kN force produces a clockwise moment at point E, so this is the force, 2 kN, and please see where the cursor is, this is the perpendicular. Okay, now the distance of this perpendicular is going to be equal to how much? This is 2 meters obviously. Okay, so let me put a negative sign, clockwise moment, because of this 2 kN force, 2 multiplied by simply 2. 2 is the force and 2 is the perpendicular dropped or the perpendicular distance. Similarly, this 3 kN force also produces a clockwise moment at point E. hence a negative sign. Name of the force is 3 multiplied by, if you watch carefully, from point E, if you try to drop a perpendicular onto the line of action of this force 3 kN, this is the distance. And this distance is nothing but 2 plus 2, that's 4, is equal to 0. Now guys, it's pretty simple now. You just need to solve this equation and you're going to get the value of F1. But there is a small problem. We need to find the value of TE. Okay, how can TE be calculated? Okay, so I'm going to do that geometrical calculation over here, over this portion. If you watch carefully, DE is equal to DP minus EP. All right, so I can essentially write this as TE is equal to DP minus EP. So what's DP, man? So DP is nothing but 2 meters. So I can write this again, 2 minus EP. So what I need now is the value of EP. Now guys, watch carefully. In triangle GPE, if you watch carefully, in triangle GPE, we need to find the value of EP. Okay, we've already got the value of theta in the form of 7.125. So I'm gonna go ahead, I'm going to use tan theta, that is tan of 7.125 is equal to perpendicular. If this is theta, this is going to be the perpendicular EP, okay, whose value is supposed to be calculated, whole divided by this base GP. GP is how much? 2 meters. So I'm going to write 2 over here. Okay, you just need to solve this. EP will eventually work out as 0.25 meters. So that's the value of EP. Okay, and what you need to do is you need to put this value of EP over here and you're going to get the value of DE is equal to, okay, let me write this again. D is equal to how much? 2 minus 0.25, and that's 1.75. So we've got the value of DE. All right, now F1 multiplied by what? 1.75 is equal to 2 plus into 2 is 4, 4, 3 is 12, 12 plus 4 is 16, 16 whole divided by 1.75. So F1 is equal to 16 divided by 1.75, and this is equal to 9.14 kN. Okay, let me write this again. The value of F1 computed is equal to 9.14 kilonewtons. Now let me highlight this value. Okay, so right now we took the moment about point E, okay, which was below the section, and hence forces above the section were considered. All right, now, and moment equation was framed. Okay, again we'll be considering the upper portion of this section and we'll try to frame the f of x is equal to 0 and f of y is equal to 0 equation. Now first of all, I'm going to kick off with this summation of all the forces in x direction is equal to 0. Okay, so let's go ahead and let us try to frame this equation. Okay, so we've got this force F1. Okay, if you watch carefully, this is headed towards the left hand side and hence negative. So I'm gonna just write over here negative of F1. What else? Okay, if you watch carefully, this F of 3 force is slightly inclined. That means it's going to have two components. One horizontal, okay, this way. Now guys, you have to be very careful. This is theta, 7.125, okay? And if you watch carefully, this red colored line and the one that I've made just now, these two are absolutely parallel. That means the angle over here, okay? This angle is theta, this angle is also going to be theta. If this is F3, please see where the mouse is hovering. If this is F3, then this has got to be F3 cos 7.125 or F3 cos theta, simply. And it's going to have one more component in the vertical direction this way. The name of this component is nothing but, where can I write this? F3 sine 7.125. Now, right now, we're interested in all the forces, or working out all the forces in the x direction. So we've got this force, F1, okay, left hand side, and we've got this force also, F3 cos 7.125 headed towards the left hand side. F3 cos 7.125 is equal to 0. All right, so essentially we've got this worked out. what I need to do is F3 will be equal to negative of F1 divided by cos of 7.125. We just need to solve this equation and we'll get the value of F3. Okay, so put the value of F1 over here, that is 9.14, and solve this equation, and you will ultimately get the value of F3 is equal to negative of 9.21 kilonewton. So that's the value of F3. All right, now finally we are going to end up by using this equation of equilibrium. Summation of all the forces in y direction is equal to zero. So you are considering the upper portion of the section. All right, so you can clearly see that there is this force F2, okay, downwards negative, minus F2, again this 2 kilonewton force is there, 3 kilonewton force is there, downwards minus 2, minus 3, what else? So we've got this F3 sine 7.125 force also acting in the downward direction. Again, let me write this, minus F3 sine 7.125, and all of this stuff is going to be equal to zero. From this equation, you need to find the value of F2. Okay, that can be done pretty easily. Let me show you. F2 eventually will be equal to, shifted this minus F2 over to this side, it becomes positive, and minus 2 minus 3 is obviously minus 5, again a minus sign, F3. So the value of F3 is how much? Negative of 9.21. Negative of 9.21 multiplied by this sine 7.125. Sine 7.125. So you just need to solve this equation and you'll get the value of F2 is equal to negative of 3.86 kilonewton. This is an approximate value. Okay, so that's F2 minus 3.86. Negative sign indicating that this member, DE member, is under compression. That's it. And this F3 was along member, what do you call this? EC member is also under compression. The only member which is under tension is this one member. Okay, that is this FD member is under tension, since the value of axial force computed was in positive sign. All right, now let me go ahead and highlight the answers. Here we go. So guys, that was all from my side for today. If you've got any doubt or query, do write them down in the comment section below. I'll be very happy to answer them. And if you believe that this video tutorial has added value to knowledge of mechanics, then do share and like this video, subscribe to this channel, and also recommend this channel to your friends and classmates so that all of them can benefit. I'll be coming up with more such videos on different sorts of problems from different sorts of topics. Until then, it's a wrap. This is Manas Patnaik signing off. Take care, have a great day, and keep learning.